That was Rihanna and it was Ponder Replay. It's all right now, it's all sorted. I was just getting off my bike and didn't manage to get time to put my skirt on, my school skirt, so I put trousers on, all that, but still in the school uniform top wise. I'm at Maidvale Studios and we've got Noel, we've got Andy and we've got Gem from Oasis. Morning.
Hello there.
How are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
I've got a cold.
Have you?
Yeah.
Oh, just the beginning of cold or the end of it?
It's
or
the end of it.
In the thick of it.
I got it off this lot in Japan.
No, you got it off me.
What were you doing to catch a cold?
No.
We were doing
close proximity.
Bonding.
Pre-gig necking.
and Gem, you all right?
Yeah, great.
Yeah, doing good?
Got rid of me cold.
Let's go. Well, pass it on nicely. You look like you're in the firing squad. I've got you sitting right dead opposite me. V Festival, congratulations on V.
Yeah, it was pretty good.
Did it feel good to you? Because the reports have all been good.
Yeah, we had two really, really good nights. And we thought the second one was better than the first one, but I was a bit tipsy for the second one, so that probably has something to do with it. I can't believe I just said the word tipsy, but I was...
Look what's happened to you. Look how you've changed.
I was a bit drunk for the second one, but... Yeah, it was all right. I enjoyed it.
And so what's the theory as to why that was so good and other festivals that you've done haven't been to that standard or that level of enjoyment? Why has it happened?
Well, the first Glastonbury we done was amazing. The second one, we played too many new songs. The last Glastonbury we'd done, we'd only had a new drummer the night before, and it was kind of the wrong time for us, really.
Yeah.
The time we played Reading, I don't know, I can't remember that. I think it was raining. I don't know.
Do you go on ahead, you know, when you were going on stage, do you think, yeah, it feels all right, everything feels good, we're all in good spirits, good moods, getting on well?
No, we've never, all the stuff about Glastonbury last time where we were supposed to have had a big row backstage before, that's all nonsense. I don't know where that comes from, you know. Every time we go on stage, we always feel really, you know,
happy.
Yeah, relaxed. Yeah, and sometimes it doesn't happen, you know. Sometimes it does. We're not kind of robots, you know, like Westlife or anything like that. You know, it's never on tape. So, yeah. You know, some nights it's good and some nights it's not, and you can't explain why.
Okay, but you had fun on stage and a bit of rapport with the audience as well.
It's all Liam had been on the sauce as well the two nights before the gig. So
right,
I think
that helps.
Yeah. It doesn't hurt. Yeah.
Where is he today? Because our last live lounge we heard from Oasis, it was just Liam.
He's in the Priory.
He's in the Priory.
He's
which particular addiction is he addressing now?
He's no. Let's ruin his holiday. Is any of the paparazzi's listening? He's at Lake Como with his missus. Get on that. That's in Italy, by the way.
Is he a guest of George Clooney? He's got a pad there, isn't he?
I don't know. I don't know. If you take, I don't know. If you take the sea off the front of that, and George Looney. Maybe.
I mean, are you not allowed to do anything together again, or is it just
me and him?
Yeah.
Well, there's no point in me and him getting around in a situation like this because he contradicts everything I say, whether he really believes in it or not. You know, so it's just annoying. I just end up punching him. So.
Oh yeah, probably best that doesn't happen.
Yeah, not totally. Yeah.
Also, going off and doing V at the moment, you're just in a brilliant position, aren't you? Being in Oasis, the album's been so well received. This single's going down really well. Video's fantastic.
Yeah. It's we've just come back from where have we been? We've been to Japan. And we're off to America. I'm actually off tomorrow. These are off the week after, and it's where we're finishing off for Kasabian and Jet. I think it's going to be great. It's the first time we've been to the West Coast for a few years because we had to pull the last one because Liam had no teeth.
Mm. But I just read an interview and he was denying anything about that.
Denying anything about what?
About the teeth.
What that ever happened?
Good boy. Yeah.
Oh, believe you me, it happened. But we had to pull the last West Coast tour because he didn't have any teeth and he wouldn't have been able to sing Supersonic. It'd have been Supersonic, couldn't it? I'm looking forward to going.
But it feels good in America as well, doesn't it? I mean, the Madison Square Gardens selling out.
Yeah, that was all the gigs we've done on the East Coast were great, and the album. This one has been by far and away it's been better received over there than it has over here.
Yeah, totally.
We've not had one bad review over there. It just seems to have come around again, and it's a lesson in longevity, I think, just to stick it out and it always comes back around, I think.
Okay, you can do the single for us first.
We are indeed.
Excellent.
You ready?
Yep.
Time.
cause the man don't pay me. I begged my landlord for some more time and he said, son, your bills are waiting. My best friend called me the other night. He said, man, are you crazy? My girlfriend told me to get a life. She said, boy, are you lazy? I don't mind as long as there's a bed beneath the stars that shine.
It's a great song. It's Oasis live on Radio 1 from Maida Vale. That was The Importance of Being Idle. It's looking good in the midweeks that we don't talk about.
What are you talking about?
Might have a number one record.
Screaming there to number one.
Do you reckon?
That'll be our first consecutive number ones ever.
It's good in the moment, isn't it?
It's brilliant, yeah. It's
all right. Right, we'll get some more live music in just a minute.
The Live Lounge.
That was The Audio Bullies and it was Shot You Down. It's Joe. I'm over at Maida Vale in London with Oasis. We've got Noel, we've got Andy and we've got Gem, and you've just missed The Importance of Being Idle if you've only just turned on now. Did you hear the Foo Fighters the other day? We had them 2 days ago.
They've just played it to us in there.
So you've heard what they did?
Yes.
Okay. Can I play it in so you can hear it again?
Yeah.
All right, this is the Foo Fighters from 2 days ago then, doing Lila.
Hey, Lila, the star's about to fall, so what you say?
Rendition. I think they'd only done it once or twice before.
Sounds like Motorhead doing Green Day on acid.
They did it live. I went and saw them last night, and they.
I do like Motorhead, Green Day, and acid. So that's actually a compliment.
Now they did about 2 minutes of it live last night. So right. I wouldn't be surprised if they do it when they do Reading and Leeds as well. They might have changed the lyrics though.
Oh really? Mm. Oh, they'll be in for my lawyers if they have.
I'm sure. You haven't got a cover version of Foo Fighters cover version lined up for us?
No. No, when they was asked to do a cover version, it's like we
can't be asked.
Well, that's generally the short answer. Yeah, the long answer is I was thinking, and then I thought I can't bother.
Would have been really nice.
No, I know it would have been great, but we've all been away, so we've not had a chance to work anything out.
They reckon that you only like one Foo Fighters song anyway,
which is what
I think. What was it? Learn to Fly all times like these.
What the Foo Fighters reckon? We don't like any.
And that'll get back to them probably by now, actually.
No, if you're listening, David.
You're playing together in Cardiff anyway, so...
We are, yeah. Face. We are at the end of the year. So that is going to be an immense night. That's going to be great. How we've wangled all those bands on the bed. It must have cost us a fortune or all that. But I'm actually... Even if I wasn't in the band, I'd go to that.
And what's the idea behind it? What was the motivation?
I don't know. Some of the people who were putting it on come on to us and said they're going to start an end-of-year kind of indoor festival thing. And they said, would you be up for doing it? And we said, yeah. And then we said, well, if you're going to do it, you better get some... Don't put it on like Oasis and... Like a load of no marks underneath. If we're going to play the Millennium Stadium, better make it a special lineup. And then they said, can we use your name, the Noise of Confusion thing that we use for ours? He said, go on then. And as far as I know, it's going to be an end of year. I don't know whether it's going to be in the Millennium Stadium every year. Obviously not, I would have thought, because we can't play it every year. But
it's going to be a great event.
Yeah, because I think the idea behind it was there's no festivals around Christmas. Obviously, it's too cold. So the idea was to put on an indoor one, which I think is a great idea.
I know, but also it's a great celebration of a really good year of music.
Well, yeah, I think isn't the idea behind it that all the bands who kind of come through and do well in the year are asked to play it? Yeah,
okay.
and one of the big boys headline. And we've been asked to do it first.
You're the big boys this year.
We are the big boys, yeah.
That's good. Were there any bands that you had trouble getting because Liam slagged them off so much in the past?
Listen, Liam neither likes nor hates anyone. He doesn't listen to music. He's not into music. All he's into is the sound of his own head, which is kind of goes a bit like this.
Elevator music.
Yeah, totally, man. He's not, you know, he's always slagging bands off, but he's never even heard of the Kind of
Chiefs. Do you not get the comeback? Do you not get them coming up to you going, what's the problem? And getting aggravation?
Always a little spotty urbits don't approach me anywhere, man.
Really?
No chance.
He's so hard. Have you started to
die? No. I mean, I wouldn't. I'd, in fact, if one of the Kaiser Chiefs ever came up to me and said, you're kidding me, start, I mean, I'd shake his hand for a bit. I'd be like, yeah, you've got some front you have. I actually like the Kaiser Chiefs and Winkle Pickers. I think that was his only beef with them, was that they wear Winkle Pickers.
The Winkle Pickers, that was the problem. Mm. Good band. Who else are you liking at the moment? Have you just been working on this album? You've not had time to go out and see anyone?
I like the Coral's new album. And I like... There isn't one band, I think, apart...
Arctic Monkeys, have you seen heard them?
No, I'm not having that name for starters. They're never going to get anywhere with a name like that, are they?
Bet they do.
No, I bet they don't.
Bet they do. How much do you want to
bet? I bet you 50 quid, the Arctic Monkeys never win a Brit Award or a Grammy.
Okay, 50 quid.
50
Done.
Quid.
Right.
Kasabian.
And the winner is... The Arctic Monkeys. No, it doesn't. Does it sound
Handed
like
over
to you?
Gallagher.
Does it sound like to you? And the winner for the greatest act of all time goes to... Oh, they just shaded it with the Beatles. It's the Arctic Monkeys. No, I don't think so. No, Kasabian.
Watch this space. Do you reckon?
Yeah.
You're still loving them.
Aren't they great? We've had the record for ages, but we've only just seen them live over the last couple of months, and they're brilliant. Serge and Tom are just genius, particularly Tom. He is genius.
Well, you played your part, in... inspiring them anyway, didn't you?
So they say.
Okay. You're going to do a classic Oasis track for us now?
Apparently.
Okay. What's it going to be? Let me guess.
You'll know after about 4 seconds.
Nanosecond.
You've got to get this right, though. The pace of it's crucial.
If you mess up, just stop and start again.
Join in then. There'll be someone in Leeds now going... What is it? I don't know what it is.
Today was gonna be the day they were gonna throw it back to you. By now you should have somehow realized what you gotta do. And I don't believe that anybody feels the way I do about you now. A backbeat, the word was on the street that the fire in your heart went out. And I'm sure you heard it all before, but you never. gonna be the day when they'll never throw it back to you. By now you should have somehow realized what you're not to do. I don't believe that anybody feels the way I do about you now. And all the roads I have to walk are winding. And all the lights that light my way are blinding.
That was Pussycat Dolls, former record of the week on the show, of course. Still over at Maida Vale with Oasis. We did this with various different bands we had the other day, band on band action. If I could just divide you up and ask you different questions. I've never seen you look scared like that before. All of you, the whites of your eyes. Andy, you can answer questions about Noel. Noel, you can do Gem. And Gem, you can do Andy.
Yeah.
Okay. One word to describe them then. Andy, one word to describe Noel.
Jovial.
Noel, Gem. One word to describe Gem.
First thing that comes at the end, though, go on.
Instinct. First passion coming through here.
That can't do it in one word.
It's got to be...
Geordie.
And Gem, how do you feel about that?
Champion.
Gem, one word to describe Andy.
Is that a word?
Nonchalant.
Nonchalant. Yeah, he's pretty cool and casual. Okay.
Thank you.
What's Noel's secret talent? Something that would surprise us. Has he got some kind of bar trick that he does, or something that we don't know about?
He's a very good drunk.
A very good drunk?
I was going to say something along the lines of pulling pints as well, man.
I'm a very, very good drunk. A very good drunk.
In what way?
I'm just brilliant.
I've never ever seen
shit it's my question.
Sorry. Yeah, yeah.
His eyes tear up and he becomes extremely loved up.
Oh, really?
No, I don't at all. I've just become really funny. What are you ever
saying? He's a bad sober.
Yeah.
Grumpy when sober. Yeah, quite totally. Nice when drunk.
Might I get a tear in my
eye? You do?
No, I don't.
Does he do that?
No, I don't.
You get a glow.
No, you'll be getting a tear in your eye in a minute.
Andy, what's the nicest thing he said about you, Andy? When he's had the tear in his eye, what's the nicest thing he said about you?
Oh, you can have that second track on the album.
Well, plenty of nice things.
Okay. Noel, about Gem, a secret talent or something that we don't know about?
Secret talent?
Yeah.
Secret talent?
Gem's obviously quite an enigma to you.
Yeah, are we? Totally. Gem's secret talent. He doesn't look it, but he can drive.
Yeah, and you can't.
I can't. He doesn't look like he can drive, but he can.
You look like a man that can drive.
No, he doesn't. Look at him.
It's hardly a talent, though. But yes, I know exactly what he means. Yeah, I like to think of myself as a non-driver.
When you said to me, I'll put you up in the car, I was like, what car?
But he's a weird passenger. Imagine driving around in the front.
Why? In what way? What's
it's
he like?
It's just weird, man.
I'm great when I'm drunk, though. I'm the best drunk passenger of all time.
And Gem, Andy, what's his secret talent?
I can drive too.
The emergency dat's going to kick in.
He can't drive, actually.
Can you not drive?
No, I hate being in his car.
I can too.
You cannot.
Can you swim?
Like a fish.
You don't look like a swimmer either, you see.
I can swim and drive.
I can't swim.
Andy can swim and drive.
I can't. I can neither swim nor drive.
You can't swim or
drive. That's true, actually.
Why may you have to try swimming when I'm drunk?
You'll sink like a stone. Gem, can you swim and drive?
I can swim and drive.
Okay, so I think we know the talented ones in the band then. We've established that.
Yeah, it's the non-swimming, non-driving drunk.
You need to get out of anywhere.
It's always a pleasure having you on the show. Thank you so much. It's been great today.